Hey, Shalom. First, I'd like to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shah, Bahashim, Rakakadash, Yahweh, who the world ignorantly calls God, Yahweh Shah, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus. I want to give a double honor to the apostles, a great millstone who has taught me this truth. I want to give a peace and blessings to the Akim across the four corners of the earth who teach this truth and which like to do so. It's going to be a quick video. Lord willing, the video is edifying. Lord willing, I can get something from this video. Basically, it's going to be a quick video, man, just about, you know, the electing Yahweh Shah and our walk. That we have to do on this side, man. You know, it's not easy, you know, and it's not meant to be easy, you know. You know, we've been sinful, you know, we've been wicked, you know, we've been marinated in Babylon juice, you know what I'm saying? So we gotta break the you know, we gotta break that old man, you know, and cast them, you know, cast them off, because the old man and the new man, you know, they're gonna fight, bro. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, it's a war. You know, and whatever one you feed is the one that's gonna win. You know, and sometimes, you know, that old man could put pressure on you, so to speak. You know, for lack of better words. You know what I mean? It could, sometimes you be lusting. You know what I mean? And over to do crazy shit, dumb shit, you know what I mean? And ain't nothing but Satan, you know? And what you got to look at is that, see, Satan has the people in the world already. He has the people in the world. So that's not a fight for him. That's not a fight for him. Because these people are conforming to the world. These people, you got to think about it. Your average everyday person that you run across, right, is if they're not in this, you know, in this truth, or are they not, you know, a part of that one third, that number, or the elect, which the majority is not, right? Because scriptures say that, you know, the drop is compared to a wave, you know, that's as far as how the destruction gonna go in Sirach. I'll try to get it a little while, I'll remember it before I end the video. But they're like, you know, extras in a movie, man. Like these people, you know, the destination of these people. These people are, they can't snap out of this shit. It's like, gosh, like, goodness gracious. They can't snap out of it. It's like the Matrix. These motherfuckers is plugged in and in tune. They, you know, they go through the same shit every day. They do the same. They're on a pattern every day. They have a same ass routine every day. That's why depression is at an all time high. Like, you go to work, you come home, you deal with your woman, right? If you got kids, you deal with them, you know? And then they, you know, they indulge in any other wicked activity. See, brothers, the difference between us is that we have order about ourselves. You know, we understand, not only do we have order about ourselves, we understand prophecy. We understand the things to come. We understand the Lord. We know his name, you know? We know his name, man. And hold on. You know, we know his name, and we know ultimately what's, you know, what's going to happen to this wicked ass society. You know what I mean? So, you know, the Lord is a blessing, because we got, you know, he put his mercy on us, man. He, you know, so therefore this grace period, we got time to get this truth, understand, and get right before the marriage. Okay, now this is Romans 8:24. It says, for we are saved by hope, but hope that is seen is not hope. See, hope that is seen is not hope. So you might explain this to certain people, like, oh, you, what? You talking to, you don't even know, bro. Like, you never even met that brother. You on FaceTime or doing a video call with that man across, you know, he live in Detroit. Like, how you, you know, you don't even know that man. Whoop the whoop, you know? But we're all connected through the spirit, regardless if brothers ever met each other or not. You know, we all, and Yahweh Shah is the chief cornerstone. But we all believe in his truth. We all have hope. We all have confidence, which builds our faith, right? Our confidence have a great recompense of reward, like it says in Hebrews 10. You know, it says, for we are saved by hope, but hope that is seen is not hope. For we, it's like it, for what a man seeth, why doth he hope for? So if you see something, what you hope for? These people don't hope for shit, you know? And mind you, if Yahweh Shah was back today, these people would hate him just like they hate us. You know, that's why scriptures say the world hated him. So the world hated us because it hated him. We carry in this light. We're illuminated. We can't be hid. Right? We're giving out the warning. These people don't. Yet these people are depressed and, you know, these people just, you know, fucking going off edge, right? But yet you try to tell them the truth. You try to tell them what's to come. They hate you. These people got demons on them, man. Period. Okay. This truth, the way this walk is a normal thing. Living in this world is abnormal. You know, we're not living in this world, but indulging in this world is abnormal. Okay. Doing this sinful ass shit, man. Conforming to this homosexuality shit and all this bullshit, man. Gang activity, shootings, killings, you know, pimping, prostituting, right? You know, yeah, we listen to the music and shit like that, but them motherfuckers in this music don't even be doing half the shit that they talking about. More than half, you know? It's Romans 8 and 24. It's shit, entertainment. That's exactly what it is. And it's like watching a movie. It's entertainment. But this shit is pushed, and you everyday people eat it up and act out this foolish act. These foolish things, man. It's Romans 8 and 25. It says, but if we hope for that which we see not, then but if we hope for that we see not, then do we with patience wait for it. Okay? Yeah, and with patience, then when you go into patience, it actually goes into suffering. Okay? Because as you know, we hasten in the day, we look like you suffer. Right? Because you're like, damn, man, you gotta get up, go to work. Some brothers is working 60 plus, 70 plus. I know myself right now, like, you know, like working is at an all-time fucking high rate. I'm like, damn, bro, like, why I gotta go in at 8 o'clock and leave at 9 o'clock? Like, damn. And then you still gotta make time for the gym, you still gotta make time for your woman or women, you still gotta make time to do videos, which comes first before anything, right? You still gotta make time, you know, to call brothers, be brotherly, you know what I mean? You still gotta make time to do all this. You still gotta go out on the highways and buy. So Esau got your just, he's spreading you thin. Okay? Spreading you thin, right? It says, but guess what? Esau and you, Jake, that's in league with Esau, y'all gonna get a punishment, you know, because Mark 9 and 42 tells you, if you offend one of the little ones, which you have, I'm one of the little ones, Lord willing. If you offend one of the little ones that believe in Yahweh Shai, Yahweh, Yahweh Shai, it is better that a millstone was hung about your neck and you were cast into the sea. Okay? I'm going to jump down to 28. It says, and we know that all things work together for good to them that love the Most High, to them who are the called according to His purpose. Right? And we're called according to His purpose. Right? We're called. We're definitely called because we got this truth. Now we wait to see if we're chosen or not. If I'm chosen or not. I'm called. You know, Lord willing, I'm chosen. Okay? Part of His purpose is walking after Him. Part of His purpose is bearing your cross daily. 29, it says, for whom He did foreknow, He also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of His Son, that He might be the firstborn among many brethren. Okay, let me and conforming, you know, to the image, because scripture tell you kiss the Son, at least He be angry. How do you kiss the Son? Right? Follow the law, statutes, and commandments, do what He told us. Hold what you have until He come back, right? Stay in His truth, be brotherly, slug you. Study, right? Occupy yourself in prophecy, be obedient, you know. Do what you know, do what brothers is telling you to do, because brothers won't tell you anything that'll harm you, man. And that's a beautiful situation to be in, because 9 times out of 10, these niggas out here tell you something that'll harm you, especially if it's for their benefit. And even if they ain't telling you something that's they gonna harm you, whatever they do, 9 times out of 10 is for their fucking benefit. Okay? It's 29, it says, for whom He did foreknow, He also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of His Son, that He might be the firstborn among many brethren. Okay, let me jump down to 31. It says, let me go to 30. It says, moreover, whom He did predestinate, them He also called. Right, because the Lord knew us in the belly. Okay, we were already set out to do this ministry. We were already set out to walk this walk. Our names is already picked out. I didn't have any idea that I'd be doing this, man. I'm sure brothers haven't had any idea that they was going to do this too. You know, most brothers, you know, I had other things planned, you know, in the world, so to speak. But all that shit is nothing, man. It's a bad investment, indulging into this world, man. Forsaking this truth, that's a bad investment. You tripping. You tripping. This shit ain't, it ain't worth it. You know, because why? I think even scriptures say, you know, why, if you, what is it, how I go? Why, why indulge, you know, in this world, you know, in this present world? Some like basically saying, like, why indulge in this world, you know, for a moment? You know what I mean? You know? It says, moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called, and whom he called, them he also justified, and whom he justified, them he also glorified. It says, what shall we then say to these things? If the Most High be with us, before us, who can be against? So I'm gonna run it back. It says, what shall we then say to these things? If the Most High be for us, who could be against us, man? And that's a beautiful scripture, beautiful, powerful scriptures. If the Most High be for us, who could be against us? Nobody. So that's why, you know, even though we're in this flesh, but that's one of the things you got to remember when Esau tried to bring his hammer down, man. You know, you got to remember that. Yeah, Second Esdras, I said Sirach, Slucky. Second Esdras 9 and I start at 15. It says, I have said before, and now do speak, and will speak it also hereafter, that there be many more of them which perish. I quoted this earlier. There be many more of them which perish than of them which shall be saved. Like as a wave is greater than a drop. So many more of people are going to perish than them that are going to be saved, man. Okay. It says, like a wave is greater than a drop. Like a wave is greater than the drop. So the mass majority of people would be that wave, that drop would be that remnant. That drop would be the elect. That drop would be the one third, which the elect is part of the one third. Okay? Period, man. You know, so this is why we stay in the fight. This is why we indulge in staying as true to the best. We got to, man. We don't have a choice, man. We got to. You know, the Lord has you know, the Lord called us, man. You know what I mean? And we hope to be saved. I hope to be saved, man. But while we on this journey, man, fight the flesh, man. Fight the flesh, you know. Fight it, man. Feed the spirit, okay? Pray more. Go in your closet, man, okay? Like the brother in L.A. say, man, get in your closet. It's beautiful, you know. So with that, man, Lord willing, the video was edifying. Lord willing, I came, got something for this video. I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh. Bahashim, Yahweh Shah, Bahashim, Rekha Kadash. I want to tell you, brothers, keep pushing on to the next. Shalom.